Sacked Australian cricket coach Mickey Arthur has reached a confidential agreement with Cricket Australia. Following a marathon 13 hours of talks at Fair Work Australia, the South African says he's really happy with the result.
There was a lot of things that had to be signed off, and my legal team did that exceptionally well. So, no, just really happy it's all done.
Arthur had been seeking $4 million in compensation. He says he significantly reduced his claim to reach an agreement sooner. A Queensland man has been charged over an explosion which maimed a young boy. Glenn Charles Dell is accused of making a device which a group of teenagers found and threw at a 15-year-old, leaving him without the use of his hands.
Pins and needles, stinging pains for all the nerves growing back.
I want to be able to look this man in the eye and wants
ask
to...
ask him why.
The 43-year-old has also been charged over 2 kilos of explosives found at his property. A Perth coroner has found it took too long for authorities to act after an asylum seeker boat capsized off Christmas Island last year, killing more than 100 people. Alice Pooley reports.
Well, the coroner said the deaths were a tragedy, and if the rescue effort had been initiated sooner, all those lives could have been saved. 102 people died when their boat capsized just north of Christmas Island in June last year. They were mainly refugees from Pakistan and had been calling Australian authorities pleading for help for almost 2 days before their boat sunk. After that, they were in the water for 10 hours before being rescued. Now, the coroner here in Perth said it was important for the Australian Coordination Centre to evaluate the calls for sincerity. But in this case, the centre believed the calls could have been exaggerated. It was also revealed there was huge confusion between Australian and Indonesian authorities as to who was responsible for that area of the ocean. The Indonesian authorities were unhelpful, their efforts inadequate. Now, the boat itself was grossly overcrowded. It was ridden with termites and it wasn't seaworthy. The crew too were vastly inexperienced. The coroner recommended Australia work with Indonesia to improve communication and language problems between their rescue agencies. But he was also highly critical of our federal government for keeping a report into the tragedy a secret as a classified document. It meant that WA police, who flew to Indonesia to investigate the deaths, couldn't have access to it. They effectively doubled up on their workload and wasted their time. Now, that report has been promised to be released after today. It's back to you.
Investigations are underway into a car accident in Perth which killed a mother and her 2 young children. Police say the 28-year-old woman and her sons, aged 3 and 6, were on their way to school when their car collided with a truck.
It's a horrific scene. This is a tragedy not only for the families involved, the family involved in this crash. It's a tragedy for the local community.
The truck driver suffered minor injuries. It's believed he swerved to avoid another car. Smokers could soon have to pay more for their cigarettes. The Prime Minister today hinted at an increase in tobacco tax in a bid to save lives and reduce the $31 billion spent each year on smoking-related health care. If the rise goes ahead, it's forecast to raise more than $5 billion over 4 years. The Heart Foundation says Australians consume too much salt, causing strokes and heart attacks. On average, adults consume more than 3 kilograms a year, while children eat 2.2 kilos. Experts say that's more than 3 times the recommended amount.
By far the majority, perhaps even 75% of the salt we consume is sort of hidden within the foods that we eat.
6,000 deaths could be avoided each year if daily sodium intake is reduced by half a teaspoon every day. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 19 degrees in Townsville, 15 degrees in Brisbane and in Sydney, 12 at the moment in Melbourne, 8 degrees in Adelaide and 14 in Perth.